I started my business when I was 24 years old. I had two young children and was a single mom. My grandfather and my father are both very good bakers, were very good bakers. And told my father about my dreams and my plan. He says, "You're a woman, you're not a baker, hands off." I said, "Are you going to help me or are you not?" And he says, "Okay." He gave me some seed money. So started retail the way I knew it. And business grew very quickly from there. Within the first 3 years, we've had $3 million of sales. And I did a third of the volume in the beginning of the week, two-thirds towards the end of the week with the wholesale that had to come. People wanted the product. We started having trucks. We started selling fresh product to restaurants, hotels, supermarkets, that sort of thing. And by 1993, it was clear that I didn't want to be in retail and I wanted to have my product with a shelf life. So I went back and looking at what was happening in Europe. There was a method called pre-proofed frozen, which is when you develop a piece of dough and instead of baking it, you're freezing it at the proofed stage. So anybody who's a baker or has done some home baking, you know when your product is ready to go in the oven. Instead of in the oven, you put it in the freezer. You do that usually at about 80% of proofing. And the European bakers are doing this quite successfully because they ship their product within a fairly short radius multiple times a week and they bake it off as needed on location. And it gives you a perfectly fresh baked product. As it turned out, that wasn't working for Canada and North America because of our deliveries and our distances and how the whole distribution system worked. So after moving into the facility we're in currently, which is in Vaughan, where today have back then we had 32,000 square foot. Today we have 54,000 square foot, and we started constructing this. Bought new equipment. It got all perfectly engineered for pre-proofed frozen, except for halfway through construction, I realized this is not what the market wanted and had to switch horses for heavier equipment to get into par-baked frozen, which is when your product is finished baked. Par-baked is a bit of a misleading word. It's you cannot bake bread twice. It's like pudding. You have to bake it the first time right. It cannot recover if it's still doughy on the inside. So what you do is you're baking it with a soft crust. Initially, that was the way. We had to bake it quite white with a soft crust and then freeze it, let it cool slightly, and then freeze it, blast freeze it immediately after to conserve all the moisture and all the freshness. And what the retailers and the food service operators are doing is they're putting it back in the oven and they're crusting it up, freshening it up, and then serving it this way or selling it that way. It evolved quite a bit over the last, well, since in the mid-90s, late-90s, from this anemic-looking white soft-crusted product to now the hard-crust, the gum-plating sort of European bread that is widely available in Canada and the U.S. that's shipped frozen from manufacturers such as myself into retailers that put it back in the oven, put it in paper bag, and the consumer thinks that it's made from scratch on premises, which it isn't. And in the food service side of it as well, the distributors are getting frozen baguettes, frozen rolls for hotels, for restaurants, and they are either putting it in an oven, crisping it up, heating it up, or serving it just cold. But it's for our way of life today and for our needs of quality control and distribution control, it was the best way to take. And I'm very proud to be part of this industry. I love baking. I love bread. And I have great people. I've been able to retain a lot of people for many, many, many years. And we're growing together. And it's a great business. So I encourage anybody who has entrepreneurial dreams to get out there and make them real because it's worth it. And Canada is a fabulous country to do it with.